Let's go through this one in parts. Any regular expression starts with R single quote or R double quote. I'm going to use the single quotes this time so that I won't have to escape quite as many of these. Then we want to match the blue double quote here at the beginning. And somewhere way at the end, we'll want to match the closing one, and that'll be the end of our regular expression. So now we just have to think of what goes in here in the middle. And this may not be enough room. I may have to erase it and write it again. Well, whatever it is, it's going to be zero or more of something. And as we're going across the string, there's sort of backslashes, which are important, and everything else, which is not so important. So if there's any character that's not a backslash, and here I'm escaping the backslash, we can just read right over it. That's no problem inside our string. Or you could actually have an escape sequence, like this backslash close quote. That looks like a literal backslash followed by anything, and then it's done. So let me just diagram this a little more. Say this opening quote is one. That matches things like this opening quote in the string. Then in here, we have anything that's not a backslash. That's two. That's I space say, S-A-Y, comma. But then eventually we do get to a backslash. Over here, we have a two-character sequence that's a backslash followed by a dot. These two characters, the backslash followed by the quote, they are three. And then we're back to matching twos, H-E-L-L-O dot. And now we have another backslash and a quote, so these two together will be another three. And then this part at the end is number four. So I have zero or more copies of my string body. The elements of my string body are either normal characters or two-character escape sequences. And although this looks like three characters, it's really just two. I have to escape the backslash. As a minor aside, after the Beatles and Sound of Music examples from above, you may not be surprised to know that a number of English songs of enduring popularity, A, B, C, 1, 2, 3, B, I, N, G, O, seem to have a regular expression sort of feel. Repetition is very common in songs, and you get the same thing out of it that you get out of a regular expression, a concise notation, verses and choruses, but then when you expand it out, it takes a long time to sing. However, there is one song that is actually too complicated for regular expressions, the dreaded 99 bottles of beer on the wall. If you actually want the counting to work out correctly, 99 to 98 to 97, we can't fit it in a regular expression framework. Huh, we'll have to return to that later, and eventually we will be smart enough to sing this song. For more info on this, Don Knuth, a computer scientist, has written an essay on the complexity of songs.